The chair of a UN negotiating committee is confident countries will be able to pave the way for an international treaty to curb plastic pollution. UNINC chair Luis Valles Valdivieso said this as South Korea hosts a fifth UNINC 5 meeting this week. Talks in Ottawa in April ended without a plan to cap plastic pollution. Ongoing negotiations in Busan will focus on chemicals of concern and other measures after petrochemical producing nations like Saudi Arabia and China strongly opposed efforts to target plastic pollution.
I'm confident that we will reach an agreement here in Busan for the 1st of December. And I'm confident that text that we will agree with the member states here in Busan will give us the path to combat and to end plastic pollution with credible rules.
Social security institutions in Southeast Asia said they are open for more collaboration as delegates gather in Manila. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Jackie Pascual. Jackie?
Iran, various social security institutions in Southeast Asia collectively manage $1.3 trillion in assets, and they are considering collaborating more with each other, possibly even co-investing in projects in the region. Delegates gathered here in Manila for the 41st ASEAN Social Security Association meetings, which will start today and will end on November 27. Officials from different organizations hope for a deeper partnership as they navigate the future of social security. ASA chairperson Ahmad Zulkarnain-On, who is also the chief executive officer of Malaysia's Employees Provident Fund, said they will discuss ways how they will work with each other and invest in projects that will benefit the region as a whole. Meanwhile, Government Service Insurance System President and General Manager Jose Arnulfo Viloso, who is the ASA Vice Chairman, said that they will know the risk appetite of each member and a future collaboration is also possible. He added that the collective $1.3 trillion in assets is huge and can create a big economic impact in the region. These investments, they said, can spur regional development. They also said that Viloso also said that they may also check on investment opportunities in sectors or areas that they may not be too familiar with, and they hope to learn more from this forum. The Philippine members of ASA are GSIS, SSS, PhilHealth, Pag-ibig Fund, Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, and the Employees Compensation Commission. That's latest, Ron, back to you.
Jackie Pascual with that story. Thanks, Jackie. The Philippine Land Transport Regulator disputes claims of an unregulated rise in motorcycle taxis in Metro Manila. The LTFRB says the number of such vehicles plying roads in the capital region have stayed the same for 3 years now. It added it only allowed more motorcycle taxis in Central Luzon and in Calabarzon. Transport groups have claimed the uncontrolled rise in the number of motorcycle taxis is eating at least half of their daily income. Australia's Prime Minister downplays privacy concerns for his government's proposal to ban social media for minors. Australia plans to trial an age verification system, implementing a social media age ban for those under 16. The laws would impact Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, X, and Snapchat. The proposals are the highest age limit set by any country.
Because we're doing more than setting a new minimum age of 16 for social media, we are setting a new community standard, making it clear that social media companies have a social responsibility and sending a message to all those mums and dads who are worried about the impact that social media is having on their children's well-being, their mental health, their confidence, and their sense of self. That message is simple. We are on your side. We've got your back.